So welcome everyone to the peer-to-peer technologies and blockchain session. The background context for this whole workshop goes back to the beginning of times when the Ethereum founders realized very early on that the blockchain, the public blockchain, is basically the final missing piece in the puzzle to have a fully decentralized internet and accomplish the old new dream of completely decentralized services on the internet. So this gave rise to the idea of this holy trinity of the Ethereum ecosystem, which is like complementing the public blockchain, which has always been thought of as the central processing unit of the world, of the global world computer. And what other ingredients do you need for a world computer? Well, you need some storage and data provision service. So basically the I/O, or the hard disk of the world computer, and that was the concept for Swarm. And the third pillar is Whisper for communications. I mean, since then a lot has changed, and the Swarm project has grown in scope quite substantially. And this workshop, although I would refrain from calling it the Swarm workshop, but it's a kind of a lot of the projects that are going to be presented here are using Swarm as their backend and somehow related to Swarm technologies. So recently our team has grown, and we hiring a lot of people, and it's kind of the extension of the group is like aligns very well with the growth of the scope of the project. What do I mean by the growth of the scope? Well, apart from the base layer infrastructure to distribute content and do file and document storage and virtual hosting, we realized that the techniques that we used in Swarm can be applied to various other base layer services that are relevant for the internet, namely node-to-node real-time communication, and also database services, which are especially important because in order to have some mass adoption for the Ethereum ecosystem, it's very important that we provide tools to carry over the current wisdom of how to build web applications, how to build a web stack. And most real-time interactive web applications nowadays are based on some central database component. So it's they are kind of database driven. So if we provide some tools how to how to handle or how to manage these databases in the new paradigm of the decentralized internet, then we can help the adoption or help the migrating a lot of the current web solutions to the new paradigm. So today we're going to see a lot of very interesting presentations, and especially I'm very happy to say that some of these are quite mature, to the extent that we're going to have a possibility to demo some of the solutions. So in the first half, before the lunch break, Aaron and I will talk about swap, swear, and swindle games. The context for this is to provide some infrastructure for accounting and providing service contracts for decentralized services, and provide like efficient payment solutions, basically micropayment solutions, which allow users to save on transaction costs as opposed to like on-chain direct payments. So we're going to talk about that first, and then we're going to have a session on Truebit, which is basically off-chain verification of computation. And right after the lunch break, we're going to have the live peer who are presenting a solution using Swarm to stream media files, audio and video. They're going to have a demo as well. And then we're going to have another streaming-related talk by streamer. Later in the session, we're going to have a talk about PSS. PSS is our node-to-node messaging service on Swarm. And very closely related to that, the mainframe is going to present their communication solution based on PSS, which is basically a Slack-like alternative communication, like chat client. And this will have audience participation. So yeah, please be prepared with your gadgets if you want to take part. After that, we're going to have presentations by Big Chain DB, and to close the session, I'm gonna present some kind of instead of a proper talk, I will just present some ideas and start a conversation about how to do decentralized database services using our ecosystem. And what are the challenges and what are the requirements that we need for to have like proper decentralized services doing databases. So I hope that you're gonna enjoy these sessions. And now, without further ado, I give it over to Aaron to start the talk about SwapSware and Swindle. So enjoy.